Ken Johnson coming to you once again with a fast forward rewind. This week we in Lake Dallas with their stud right-hander, Mason Meeks. Mason, give us some insight to your season this year.
Well, as a team, it's been a really good season. We've been able to capitalize on our offense, and our defense is always solid. So whenever I pitch, I feel like I have a strong defense behind me to keep me in shape.
Is it going to be common to expect that they expect you to go out there and get the win and they're right on you as the ace?
Well, as last year, I that was my expectations. And this year, it's the same as it was last year. I have to go out and give my best and give my team the best chance to win, and my defense helps me do that every game.
On a team perspective, does it kind of feel gratifying the fact that nobody really was picking y'all at the beginning of the year? Y'all just been steady beating everybody and gave Prosper all they wanted.
Yeah, I mean, we as a team and myself personally, we love being underdogs. We were the underdogs when we made our playoff run 2 years ago, and we were the underdogs again this year. We were expected to get fourth in district, and we ended up at second, possibly getting the district championship. And that feeling of being an underdog is what keeps the fire going.
What's your confidence level at now that playoffs are right around the corner for next week coming up?
It's really high. Everyone's excited, especially since we missed playoffs last year. Everyone's real hyped up for going to playoffs this year. We got a bunch of young guys and juniors that weren't on varsity 2 years ago when we did. So everyone was here whenever we missed playoffs, and the feeling that we get from that, and that was really what fueled our fire this whole season and what's going to fuel our fire continuing after this.
Got you. Talk about the team camaraderie, because it seems like that plays a role in y'all's success on the field, the fact that y'all get along off the field.
Yes, sir. Our chemistry is probably the best of any team I've ever played for, summer or school. And I feel like that's what keeps us together. We have team bonding every single week, sometimes multiple times a week. And I truly believe that having a good team and teammates that trust in you and feel that you're truly one of their friends, then you will be a better team.
How big a deal is it to make a run and leave a legacy so that people are talking about y'all 18 years from now?
Well, it's always fun to come back, and I see there's seniors in the past that everyone knows their name and everyone knows what they did that certain season, and it's always great to leave a legacy and have memories left behind you whenever you leave.
Does it feel good the fact that your name gonna be in that group? People will be talking about you.
Yes, sir.
Years down the road.
Yes, sir. It feels great.
What's your pitching combination? For somebody's never seen you pitch, what are you bringing in? What's been your most effective pitch this year that's got you on this good trend?
Fastball. I've always been a fastball dominant pitcher. I was last year and I'm here again, but I've been able to improve on my curveball and changeup that really weren't very good last year, and that's really been able to be confident on both sides of the plate with every pitch has been able to keep me in the game like I have.
What's been your best game on the mound so far this year?
Truly, I believe it would probably be my game against Little Elm last week. I thought I pitched pretty well. It's a good team. All we have is good teams in our district, so every game's a challenge. But last week, I feel like I was able to execute all my pitches very well, and my defense helped me out behind me.
From a team perspective, when was that game that you like, hey, not only can we go to the playoffs, we could do some damage this year. Like, we know we're just as good. It's like, cause you know, it's a good thing to think you can beat people, but when you know you can beat them, it's a whole different ball game.
Probably the game against McKinney North. That our game in tournaments against Louisville. Louisville's a really good team. McKinney North is a really good team. And we were just able to put it on them early and keep them down and win a ball game. And that's when we knew that we were strong. We weren't expected to be strong, and we weren't even sure if we were going to be strong. But whenever we were able to execute, that's when we truly knew.
So when I beat them twice, what was that feeling to beat McKinney North twice and sweep that series? Oh. And nobody saw that coming?
No, McKinney North was supposed to be the 24th team in the state in preseason. And us going into game one, winning that, the first one, and then going into game two, looking for another win and getting it was a great feeling, especially last year when we got swept by McKinney North in extra innings on Friday. It was a great feeling to be able to sweep them right back.
So how's it feel to get that redemption, a beat like that theme? It's like y'all getting redemption on all these teams. How does it feel to kind of have that redemption tour that y'all had after last year?
Like I said before, being an underdog, no one really expects you to be as good as you are. And when you get that redemption, whenever you sweep a team you got swept by last year, it's a great feeling.
Now that your senior season is almost over with and stuff, what's some memories you're going to take away from this season and just playing baseball here at Lake Dallas?
Team bonding with the team is always fun. I mean, the comeback season after last year, I'm always going to remember that. But more than anything, I'm going to be able to remember playing with my brothers right next to me. I mean, every one of them I consider one of my brothers, my best friends, and I get to play a game with them that I love every single day.
What are you going to do next year? For people trying to keep up with you, where are you going to be going? And what got you to sign on that dotted line?
I signed with Drew University in Springfield, Missouri. Mr. Cade Griffiths, the owner of DBAT and a close family friend of ours, he was able to hook me up with a game at Battle of the Borders with DBAT, and I got some exposure there. And ever since then, I had more offers than I had before, and that's really where I got my recruiting from.
Who's some other people that you had offers from?
I had an offer from Wichita Baptist and Pittsburgh State.
So does it feel good, the fact that you were wanted by the colleges to take your game to the next level?
Yes, sir. The recruiting process is one of the best feelings you can feel. Being wanted by schools is amazing.
How's that individual success carried on the field this year, like getting recruited and stuff? Because some people, they feel especially, some people they thrive are like, hey, I'm a high-level pitcher. I'm a college pitcher. So what was your mindset?
Well, my mindset's always that you need to get better. You have success and you can't just lay off, because then that's when people pass you. And being recruited and having that weight off my shoulders, that gave me more focus to completing the season that's ahead of me and being successful game in and game out.
With this being your coach's second year, how's it feel the fact that y'all laying that foundation for future Falcon programs, and they know, like, it's not like next year is going to be expected, you know, y'all going to be a new district and everything, and a lot of y'all going to be moved on in college, but it's going to be expected to do this. How's that feel the fact that y'all changed the culture around here for the better and for permanently?
Well, culture is a big thing within the program and our coaching staff. We practice with our JVs. We don't practice separate, so we have to basically mentor the guys below us and make sure that the program after us is better than we left it.
So how does it feel the fact that it's better than it was when you found it?
Looking back, when I'm in college, looking back on the guys that were left behind me and seeing them succeed would probably be a better feeling, knowing that I helped mentor them and my teammates helped mentor them after we left leave them with success.
Who's two or three key players on your team that don't get the shine that somebody like you do? Everybody see you putting up all these zeros and getting a one run a game. Who's some guys that on your team that deserves a shine that nobody talks about?
Well, I believe guys that are overlooked, guys like Kyle York. He's a catcher that was able to move to second base to fill a spot that we needed to be filled. He's a very utility guy, hits the ball hard every time. Ryan Hull, our left fielder, he's a very fast dude and hits the ball very well as well. I haven't heard about very much recruiting of him, but if anything, he should be very much. And our center fielder, Ryan Depperschmidt, he's also our quarterback, so he's a two-sport athlete and he's great at both. And day in, day out, he works hard and he just does his best to participate and help the team out in any way you can.
Did the football team's good season this year kind of set the tone for y'all? Because I know at other schools that it couldn't seem to be a thing. Like, football have a good season and people take that excitement, yeah, and kind of carry over into that sport. Is that what happened here in Lake Dallas?
I believe a portion of it, yeah. I mean, 2 years ago when we made our district run, our football team also went 5 rounds deep. And the attention that football got, we won it too. And so we wanted to work and we wanted to get the stands to fill. Normally we don't this year. It's filled. Guys want to come to the game, and it's an awesome feeling when you got a crowd behind you.
Do you want to give a shout-out to Falcon Nation?
LD Nation forever. I'll be a Falcon forever. Never die.
And what's the message you want to somebody seeing this video that, man, well, how late Dallas won these games? And what's the message you want to let people know about y'all team and about what y'all represent out here in Lake Dallas?
Never sleep on the underdog. I mean, we're a borderline 4A school playing big 5A schools, and we're able to play just as well against them, even 6A schools like Louisville. And just work hard and do the best you can every game and be a good teammate.